Hey, good morning, everyone. God bless you. Thank you for watching Mike Reed Outdoors. Man, I tell you what, that fire don't feel too bad today. It's the sun shining out there, but still yet, it's a little bit on the chilly side. Muzzleloading season's coming up there just in a few days. And you all saw me last week shooting my muzzleloader and getting the powder charge and everything that I wanted in there correctly and shooting it at 25 yards. What I'm going to do today is show you some just a few things that I do with the muzzleloader before season so that I make sure everything's going to function right. What I'm doing here is checking everything out. I'm checking the lock to make sure everything is functioning correctly. I did lower the sights on it on the back just a little bit to bring the shot down on at the 25 yards to sort of put me on target there at about 75 yards range. That's about what I'll be shooting at probably here in the mountains. Unless you're hunting in the field, you generally are going to shoot at something, 50 yards and under. So let me get the camera turned around. I'll show you what I'm going to do here and explain to you why I'm going to do it.
All right, you all. If you're a traditional hunter and you're going to use your traditional firearm like this one right here, some of the things that can happen to you is, number one, you can lose your flint. Your flint will come loose sometimes. If you haven't got it tightened down correctly, and after a few shots, sometimes it'll get loose, and you can actually lose the flint and the leather that is holding your flint in place there, because you don't want to turn your screw down on top of your flint itself. So what I'm going to do is show you how to make the leather to hold your flint in. And I got some extra flints. That's what you want to have when you're traditional hunting, because, this is just a rock and something can happen to it to where it doesn't function correctly anymore. Then you're pretty much done until you make one, okay? All right, you all, inside my bag there, I've got this little bag, and I've got patches in here. I've got pre-lube patches. I've got some extra flint. So let me put that in there. What we want to do is make extra leathers to hold that flint. So what I do is I take the piece of flint, just like this right here. This is actually 5/8 flint. So we know how wide it is, see? Okay. This little knife right here, my buddy Jimmy Newton gave me, and I'm gonna make a mark right there so that I can see it. So this is not that hard to do, and I'll guarantee you all. Let's cut that section off right there. That should make two of them. Should be enough. All right. Now we want it to go around and hold that piece of flint in the gun, just like that right there. Well, that should be enough. Before you do that, cut you a little notch right here in the back of it so that it'll go up around the screw. And cut it off. And you can see the notch I've made right here so that it goes around your screw. And then that way, you won't have that pressure against it, okay? Make sure you cut those things, pre-cut those things to fit you all. Because lots of things happen to these leather, pieces right here, because even just shooting your gun will eventually deteriorate your leather. So you got to have a way to replace that stuff.
All right, that's one of the things that you can do right there. Of course, make sure that you've got all your tools in there. Make sure you got your extra powder. This time I'm not leaving without the ball starter. Although I do have preloads, you just never know. I've got the cleaning kit in here, you all, right there. And of course, I've got the extra lead shot that I'm going to need. I usually carry about 10 extra balls and stuff like that just for hunting. So I'll lay that out there and take a picture of it for you for this video. Now, sometimes I carry the powder horn and sometimes I don't. Now, a lot of times when I'm using the 54 caliber that I've got, I carry the powder horn, but not a lot of the time. When you're hunting here in the mountains and you need to get a really, really second shot off really quick, it's just a whole lot easier to take those preloads that you've already got the ball and the shot and everything in there, you know, ready to go, and you just put it down the barrel and you just hammer it home and you're ready to go and you're not fumbling around with all the other stuff. You know, I'm not against that, but sometimes here in the Virginia, you know, if you shoot a deer and you don't knock it down, you might need another shot on it, or a bear even.
So there's what the kit looks like.
And of course, you all double check your gun after you've been out to the range. Go ahead and put your cleaning patch on here. Make sure your gun's good and clean. Looks pretty good. See that rubber nozzle right there? These things work really good. That hole is cleaned out, you all. Sure enough, makes it work really, really good. Also, you all, there has been times when I have got stuff down a muzzleloader or barrel like that right there, down in the bottom of it, and couldn't get it out. Sometimes it would be like one of them broken off jags, plastic jags, and I've done that myself, and that's the reason I don't even have to stick one down a gun barrel anymore. But I have taken compressed air and went to the nipple of the gun and put that compressed air in and blow that stuff out of the gun barrel. And you can do that without sticking something down in there and trying to get it out the other way. Sometimes it works and sometimes it don't. It depends on what you got down the gun barrel, okay? I just like to teach other people that stuff every once in a while so that they will understand it as well. But anyway, you all, good luck to you this year. I hope you kill you a big old deer with some big old horns on its head. Make sure your rifle's sighted in. Make sure your powder's dry. Make sure your gun is clean. And I do recommend, if you can, you all, when I was out there practicing the other day, I shot 3 shots before I cleaned the gun. And then it was hard to load the next ball down. You know, I was using that graphite on those patches. But it didn't seem to me like it made any difference whatsoever as far as accuracy went. The greased ball shot just as good as the other one did, and it didn't load any easier after I didn't clean the gun. So I'm just going to use the regular old greased patches and go with that. And if I don't have to have a real quick follow-up shot, I am going to swab the barrel out between the shots, because that's just going to give you more accuracy. A dirty barrel will put some drag on your round. Make no mistake about it. It puts drag on your round, and it causes it not to, I don't think it twists just exactly right. This gun right here has got, let's see what this, and this is a 1/48 50 caliber. So I think that a dirty barrel does affect the shot. So especially on about the third or fourth shot, because black powder is really corrosive. Anyway, you all, like I said, God bless you. I really thank you for watching Mike Reed Outdoors. Have yourself a wonderful day.